music for girl watching. Will you get rid of that drummer, please? All right. Beat it. Not the drum, no. Welcome back with the Bobby Crew record of Girl Watching after the news at 8 o'clock with Smart Alex Bermudez reporting from the 24-hour BBF newsrooms here on the Jack Palvino Show.
Supplies and office furniture, both good and bad news as a result of the President's State of the Union message. First, the good news.
We should raise Social Security payments by an overall average of 20%. That will add $4,100,000,000 to Social Security payments in the first year. I will recommend that each of the 23 million Americans now receiving payments get an increase of at least 15%. I will ask that you raise the minimum payment by 59% from $44 to $70 a month, and to guarantee a minimum benefit of $100 a month for those with a total of 25 years of coverage. We must raise the limits that retired workers can earn without losing Social Security income.
Besides the Social Security benefit boost, the President says he intends to press the war on poverty on the home front and seek an open housing civil rights law and a modernized draft system. The bad news, the major issue, was the proposed tax increase. The request would raise the surcharge on corporate and most personal income taxes by 6%. This would cost 6 cents more for each dollar already paid in income taxes. There was silence in the audience when the President proposed to combine the Commerce and Labor Departments. They had been separated during Woodrow Wilson's presidency. And Johnson's Vietnam formula of slow pressure and patience will not sit well with either hawks or doves. One sought-after reaction to President Johnson's 70-minute State of the Union address was that of Senate Republican leader Everett Dirksen. He said the speech was so long and detailed that it gave him mental indigestion. The Lanyvard 2 satellite has gone into a preliminary orbit after being sent aloft from Cape Kennedy this morning. The CommSat spacecraft, designed to hover above the Pacific as a communications link between North America and the Far East. Locally, GOP unhappy with Democratic proposals. Further details from WBBF's Ed Bailey.
Democrats and Republicans clashed at Tuesday's city council meeting over proposals by Mayor Frank Lamb aimed at reapportioning council districts and replacing district councilmen with councilmen at large. Both amendments to the city charter would require a voter referendum, and as Republican Vice Mayor Hyman Freeman pointed out,
Democrat member of the Board of Elections has indicated to me that it might run between $35,000 and $40,000.
Freeman said taxpayers should know what they're getting for this amount of money. But Mayor Lamb called it a very small pittance of some 12 cents and added,
this is an important milestone in the history of the city of Rochester. We want to say, as the county can say, that we have a true expression of one man, one vote.
Other Republicans, meanwhile, charged in the words of Councilman Stephen May,
it seems to me that this is a purely political smokescreen by the city administration and its majority on the council to rig the elections in November.
And Councilman Robert Wood adds still another thought on the matter.
If, in fact, Dr. Riker's lawsuit has any merit to it at all, then I think that we should allow it to go to trial.
Nevertheless, the proposals were sent to committee for further study. In other council action, a proposed study into the possibilities of a county department of transportation and a resolution to establish a Lehigh Valley Station urban renewal project were referred to committee. Ed Bailey, WBBF News.
At the conclusion of the council meeting, Assemblyman Raymond Lill, still serving as councilman, said he has contacted someone in the Thruway Authority regarding the use of rust inhibitor on streets along with the spread of salt. Lill said he was told the Thruway does not use the inhibitor. The Thruway spokesman also said that in order for rust inhibitor to be effective, it must be used on all roads, city, county, Thruway, and the like. The subject of rust inhibitor has been a controversy recently with the announcement that the city does not intend to use it on city streets. Fight and Eastman Kodak appeared to be farther apart in their dispute over Fight's demands that the firm hire 600 poor unemployed people. Representatives of the two factions met Tuesday, and Monroe Dill, Director of Industrial Relations for Kodak, opened the discussion by saying, in the words of a spokesman,
if you wish to cooperate with us to help us do the constructive things which we can do, we again invite you to endorse our program. In any event, we are prepared to meet with you to discuss orderly ways in which our two organizations might cooperate in the referral of job applicants to Kodak. If you are willing, we are prepared to discuss this subject. End of quote. The response of Minister Florence and his associates to this offer was to get up and leave the meeting.
Minister Florence later told WBBF News, Fight does not want to meet with, in his words, Kodak's fifth string. Florence says he wants to meet with someone who can sign an agreement. A one-car accident in the town of Avon on Route 39, 4 miles south of the village of Avon, has claimed the life of a 40-year-old woman, a Rochester school teacher, pronounced dead at the scene, Miss Alice Dwyer of 5 Oak Street, Geneseo. Medical examiner Dr. C.P. Andolino issued a certificate of accidental death due to neck and head injuries. Sheriff's Department deputies report Miss Dwyer's car struck a utility pole guy wire. At the Detective Bureau, police are charging 49-year-old Ann Jeffrey of 65 Frost Avenue with first-degree assault. They accuse her of wounding 49-year-old Harry Wood. She allegedly fired 4 shots at him. One of the slugs hit him in the leg. Wood was rushed to Genesee Hospital for treatment. The shooting climaxed an argument between the pair. A fire in an apartment house at 629 Lake Avenue routed 14 people from the building and sent 2 men to the hospital. 35-year-old Walter Seaball rushed to Strong Memorial Hospital for treatment of smoke inhalation after he was let out of the building by Officer Michael Landgren, and 21-year-old Mike Saplinski taken to St. Mary's Hospital for treatment of a leg injury. Firemen told WBBF News the blaze was confined to a daybed, but smoke was the major problem. The area around Midtown, a major traffic headache, says Officer Bob Dolan.
Thank you, Alex. Well, having no big problems or great changes to report, just a few words this morning to anyone about to leave the expressway at the Clinton Avenue ramp. As usual, the backup and delays are in full swing on Clinton Avenue about the Xerox building, a good deal of it brought on by the many motorists parking at Midtown Garage. In an effort to eliminate some of this, here's a suggestion that may be of some help. As you leave the expressway, make a right turn at the inner loop, then follow it through to the Union Street turnoff. Make a left turn into Broad Street and enter the Midtown area by way of the rear entrance. More often than not, this entrance is wide open, and if half the Clinton Avenue traffic would make use of it, the early downtown problems would be half as bad. Give it a try, see if you don't benefit by several minutes. Have a good day, and here's Alex at WBBF.
WBBF News Time, 808. Scranton's has an outstanding collection of world atlases by both Hammond and Rand McNally. Hammond has come up with an exclusive method of charting called New Perspective. States, provinces, even counties are distinguished by different colors. All maps are in full color. The Hammond Medallion World Atlas is priced at $19.95. The Hammond Ambassador is priced at $14.95. Another informative world atlas is the Cosmopolitan by Rand McNally. The Cosmopolitan contains new regional views of Earth from space. Rand McNally's Cosmopolitan World Atlas is priced at $16.95. All these atlases, just published in December 1966, are yours at Scranton's, downtown at 334 East Main, Northgate, Southtown, Culver Ridge, or Ridgemont. All Scranton stores except Midtown. The weather, mostly cloudy with light snow flurries today, accumulation 1 to 2 inches. The high today, 33. Fair and colder tonight with an overnight low of 15. Increasing cloudiness tomorrow with a high of 35, with light snow likely by evening. Westerly winds 10 to 20 miles an hour, becoming southwest 5 to 15 miles an hour tonight and southerly tomorrow. Our chances of snow, 30% today, 20% tonight, and 50% tomorrow. Current humidity 78%, winds out of the west at 11 miles an hour, and the barometer 30.09, it's rising. The news presented by Scranton's six convenience stores. As a further service to you, Scranton's invites you to use your charge plate for all your Scranton purchases. And when you shop Scranton's Main Street store, you get 1 hour free parking in the Stilson Street Ram Garage with a $2 Scranton purchase. Tomorrow morning, the 8 o'clock news brought to you by Columbia Banking. Current BBF temperature, 30. That's 30 degrees.
It's the Jack Palvino Show.
Goodness knows what fascinating experience is in store for us tonight. And here he is, that man about electrons.
He's smiling, Jack.
Welcome to the world of electrons and neutrons, friends. 11 minutes after 8 o'clock at the beat. I just might take off and leave. Well, see how you change your tune.
Nobody's going to want to pay.
Supreme.
I'm Supremes here at the BBF Beehive and the Jack Palvino Show at 14 minutes after 8. There's like a 100% chance of flurries right now, Daddy. Don't look out the window. Drive very, very carefully, if you will, please. Well, the Internal Revenue Service is now mailing out New Year's greetings, and then you reciprocate by telling IRS everything you did that was worthwhile in the old year, and then they say Happy New Year.
Get the old year off the books and out of the way. You've got what it takes. You've got borrowing power at Domestic Finance. Take charge. Wrap it up. You've got what it takes. Borrowing power. Make the most of your power at Domestic Finance.
Call on Domestic Finance, 37 Clinton Avenue North, 454-7630. It's 8:15 on the Jack Palvino Show.
Now, here's the WBBF Sports Watch.
San Francisco's Rick Barry pumped in 38 points last night to lead the West to a victory over the East in the NBA All-Star Game. Give them a little revenge for the shellacking they took last year. Boston Celts GM Red Auerbach returned to coaching for one game, and I don't think he's going to come back again because he was ejected in the third period when he was slapped with a second technical foul. It's the first time a coach has ever been banished from an All-Star Game. Sixth-ranked Texas Western was the only member of the top 10 in action, and the Miners beat West Texas State 85-73. Syracuse nipped Cornell in a dandy 66-65. Holy Cross defeated Rhode Island 74-66. Yale over Columbia 59-47. And I'm afraid Alfred defeated our U of R Yellow Jackets after the U of R led at the half. 62-58 final score. In the American Hockey League, Baltimore over Providence 6-1 last night. And don't look now, but Eddie Shore is at it again. This time, his coach walked out in the middle of practice saying, "I've had it. I'm throwing in the sponge. No man can live with himself without retaining his self-respect." The Shock players continue to drill, and Mr. Harry Pitherney said, "I realize Shore only wanted a figurehead as a coach, but I've got to stand or fall by myself." He's something else, that Eddie Shore. High school basketball, Gates Chilai over Penfield, 59-57. East clobbered Charlotte, 96-27. Marshall over Edison, 69-53. And at high school swimming, East Rochester defeated Jeff, 81-15. Cassius Clay has not given up on his attempt to get a draft exemption. His lawyer says the champion will push for an exemption on the grounds that he is a black Muslim minister. He was turned down on his appeal to be classed as a conscientious objector yesterday. And Mike Holovec has been given a 5-year contract with the Boston Patriots at a reported $50,000 a year. That sports will check again in 1 hour here at the Beehive. 17 now after 8 on Jack Palvino Show. How you doing, huh? 30 degrees. This is a pretty thing. Bobby Goldsboro. This is Blue Autumn. Blue Autumn. What kind of calendar you got there, man? Falling leaves in red and gold. Goldsboro, Blue Autumn, Jodine Pick here on the Jack Palvino Show at the Beehive, 20 minutes after 8. Are you going to get up this morning? 30 degrees already, going up to 33 with light snow flurries. Where'd you get that black guy,
fella? Us Terrington smokers would rather fight than switch.
No offense.
What gives Terrington the taste worth fighting for?
Just this. Terrington's got a charcoal zip, and it's got a white one, too. Together, they actually improve the great taste of Terrington's fine tobacco.
Get the charcoal zip with the taste worth fighting for. Join the unswitchables, smoke Terrington.
The way I see it, Eddie Shore has to smoke Terrington's, right? 20 minutes after 8 o'clock on the Jack Palvino Show at the BBF Beehive, 30 degrees up to 33 and down to 15 coolies tonight.
Here's an important message from Pontiac to owners of all 67 Bonnevilles, Brougham's, Catalinas, Grand Prix's, Executives, 2+2s, and Venturas. The car you're driving is not only breaking sales records all over the country, but is serving as an inspiration to other car makers who've been trying for years to follow in your wide tracks. So look sharp, fellas. Let's keep those white walls clean, those split grills shiny. And every now and then, turn on your disappearing windshield wipers so everybody will know where Pontiac hit them.
What do they call it when the two Pontiacs kind of race along the street?
Kind of a drag.
Buckingham.
Kind of a drag.
Had to believe my own stuff.
Yeah, but it's not very modest, then.
And a dandy hit record for them at 8:24 at the Beehive. We have 30 degrees and about 30 translators who are busy at work.
And that's what happened at the UN today. Yes?
Thanks, David. Big news from Furniture City in Rochester, New York. Furniture City has just purchased an entire warehouse full of Serta bedding. After 35 years, the Serta warehouse is moving from Buffalo. So Furniture City is making big news in Western New York with the greatest bedding sale in history. David?
Thanks, Chet. This Serta factory removal sale will save Rochester and Western New York shoppers hundreds and thousands of dollars on world-famous Serta bedding. Here is your local announcer with just a sample of what you can expect from this unusual sale.
Mr., I don't believe I got your name.
My name, Jose. Thank you very much, David. This great sale offers many Serta mattresses and box springs, regularly $39, now just $19.77 each. Free converter rails with purchase of any queen-size mattress. All merchandise under one roof for immediate delivery.
Well, thanks very much.
If you want to be part of this great history-making Serta factory removal sale, hurry to Furniture City, 845 Maple Street. They're open evenings till 9.
Good night, David.
Good night, Chet.
See you at Furniture City.
Alex, I'd like you to meet Ed Bailey. 825.
Love me.
Bobby Hebb.
That's all I want you to do. Just as long as your love for me is true. Want me, baby, just like a baby boy wants a toy. I'll be your pride and joy.
Me at 8:27 on the Jack Palvino Show at the BBF Beehive. 30 degrees. Drive carefully, please. It's snowing. We expect 1 or 2 inches and a high of 33. Down to 15 degrees tonight.
$250 is a lot of money. Don't blow it. On a new car deal, $250 can be the difference between a good or a poor deal. Save up to that amount on financing. Call your own independent insurance agent. Ask him to handle the financing for you through Central Trust. He'll take care of everything for you. It's the lowest rate auto financing obtainable in the area. And you don't even have to be a customer of Central Trust.
Here it comes. According to the new WBBF survey, here's the record that leads the way this week. Here's the number one song from...
Neil Diamond wrote it.
Love's only true and fairy tale.
And the Monkees sing it.
For someone else, but not for me.
The news time at 8:30. I'm a believer.
My love was out to get me. That's the way it seemed. Disappointment haunted all my dreams. Then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace.